Hi everyone and welcome to this bit unusual video. A couple of days back when I was scrolling through the comments and posts in Miriam's art group, there was a request for making an artwork with a stained glass look and if it can be made out of acrylic pouring using skins. So I wanted to give it a try and help her out as much as I can. And as the request was if this can be done with acrylic skins, I basically thought about alternatives. Because I'm really not so good with acrylic skins, and what she had in mind actually works better with a different approach. And the approach that I was going to was using window colors. If you're not familiar with window colors, you basically apply them to whatever steel surface, let them dry and you can peel them off and put them on your window or something, on a tile or wherever you want to put them at. And this is a pretty fun and easy way of creating something pretty. And therefore I gave my recommendation of using the window colors for this project. And in return she sent me the sketch that she had in mind so that I can just trace it and not need to redraw it myself. When I was younger, and this was basically about 20 years back, I pretty often used these window colors and made some sketches for my mom to decorate our home's windows, and it was really fun playing with them. So I had a couple of these bottles laying here around ever since. I wanted to give it a try and hoped for the best that these colors are still usable and not completely dry, and most of them were completely fine, which really was astounding after all these years. So I just bought two blues because I had no blues in the entire bottles that I have left and wanted to give it a go. Basically, when you plan to use window colors, there are three different types. There is the regular ones, which are just the window colors that dry translucent. There are window colors that dry opaque, which I've learned along this go here. And then you have window colors which are meant to make the outlines. So those are a bit thicker and dry quicker than the rest of the paints. These are basically meant to make the outlines to hold the other paints in shape. Basically, this is meant to look like some kind of pop art. And I myself, I do have this black line window color. I also had some in golden and silver and white. They come in many different colors, so just look out for them. And I want to show you actually two different approaches here in a live video demonstration, which is the first one is a somewhat beach scene look again, because we all love the beach scenes. And this is actually done without any of these line colors, or just the basic window color. You pick the colors that you want to use for your project and just apply it to the surface. When I started off, I realized that I do not have any white colors, so the white color that looks white here is actually a clear, a night glowing one. This was, for this project, the most whitish that I had here lying around. Of course, there is white color if you need white in your project, but just to let you know in advance. And then basically you just block in your colors. These colors are not meant to be mixed like regular acrylics to have color transitions or something. It can of course be done if you would like to do this and spend the amount of time in it. But basically this paint is just not designed to do that well. So really you basically just fill the areas with the designated paint and that's it. This went pretty quickly and you see me using different colors in the water and the sky and the planet itself. You can do that totally, but you can also use just the one plain color for it. It totally depends on the design that you have, on the final look that you are going for. And if you look in the internet for, I don't know, window color designs, you will find a million of them. Most of them are pretty much children's design, so like flowers and teddy bears and cars and such. So really basic, simple designs. But of course you can go crazy and make up your own design, like I did here in this beach scene something. And once this everything is colored, then you just put it aside. Also make sure to have not an even paint coverage all over. It will happen basically naturally that you have those areas where the paint is a bit thicker and areas where the paint is a bit thinner. This is totally fine when it looks bumpy in the very end. This will create a stained glass effect when everything is dried. So as you can see here, I filled all my areas, put it aside. It will take pretty long to dry. I think about a day or even a bit more. This depends again on the humidity in your flat, how warm it is and all the stuff. And then let's jump over to the design that Emily Marie has sent me. This was actually this tree standing on some kind of field and a bird in the sun in the sky, which looks pretty lovely. And This is just a rough sketch that I did from my screen, so I really could have taken more time to make more details and such, but this was just meant to give you all an impression how I would have approached this project. And you can do this in any size that you want. You can do this in life size, I don't know, full human body size, how big you would like to have it. And of course you can use way more time than I did here in filling all these little fields of color and trying to not cross any of the black border color and such, which happened here every now and then. And if you use way more time than I did here, you can totally improve on this as you want to go. And you can really do this on large scale. So if you're planning on do this on a Christian design stained glass church window or something, this would totally work. It just needs more time and of course a bit more of the paint. But if you would honestly plan to do something like that, I would recommend painting directly on the window in question. So not painting on the surface to peel it off in the end. Just paint it directly on the window. Probably it's best if you put it horizontal, of course. Otherwise the paint would just flow off the window. But this would be the most easy way, because peeling such a large piece off is not so much fun in the end. And for this project I used this black lining color, which you apply first to make the outlines. You let it dry a bit, an hour, 2 hours or so, until it's a bit more settled and dry to detach. And then you basically just fill out all these areas with the color that you like. And here you can see what I did. It is really pretty simple when you have your design. Everything runs pretty smoothly and quickly. I think overall I needed about 45 minutes from sketching out the black line color, including and filling out all these fields for the color. And it is really fun to make. So if you want something really quickly and easily done, and perhaps something you can do with your children or grandchildren, this is something really great to go for. It really makes fun. And that was basically it what I did for this project. Of course, if you would really like to try this, you can make something like that happening with acrylic skins as well. But these are not really translucent, or at least not that much. And from the backside, acrylic skins really do not look that pretty. If you have an acrylic pour which looks super cute from top, which is the important part, and you turn it around, it more or less is just blobs of paint. So normally you can't see it because it is made on a canvas or an MDF board or something. But if you're curious, just make one on clear film so you can see the backside once everything is dried, and you will see that all the magic is gone. So basically this is the reason why I wouldn't give it a go with a stained glass effect, because it might look pretty from the inside of your flat, but pretty ugly from the outside. And there is the cutting it to pieces part and gluing it into the shapes part and everything I just don't need to mention, I guess. So if you're going for a stained glass look, this window color is really my go-to version to give it a go. And it might end up being cheaper as well. So, hi everyone, and here we are. This is the next day. So this stuff takes a while to dry, actually. And this is the result for, the tree version of this. And this is the result of the freehand painted beach scene something. Both of them dried. Something that I really did not expect is that the brown color is opaque. Normally they are all a bit more or less translucent, as well as the gray here. So you better have a look at the bottle what it says. As those colors were pretty old, it might have changed over time as well. But well, anyways, the result is kind of pretty. I will show you in a second how it looks when you put it against the window, because this is actually the sense behind it. And when this is dry, you will actually see where your paints were a bit thicker and thinner. So you're going to have this kind of stained glass look for this. And I really like it, so give it a try as well if you like. And then when it comes to the last part, which is actually removing the painting from the surface, I usually take some kind of stick. This is a barbecue stick or something. And I more or less make this a bit red so that you have water flowing around. And then just use the stick and go under the edges and make small motions until you get rid of it. And then you can basically peel it off. So, and when the beginning part is always a bit tricky, so your edges tend to stretch a bit. But when you have a decent amount of the painting removed, everything gets a bit easier. And just put some water underneath every now and then to not make it stick again to the surface. And when you have peeled it off, you can just wet the backside of it and put it against the window and you will be fine. This stuff is going to stick forever. I think I did some of them for my mom about 20 years ago and they are still sticking to the windows. And we had to remove some of them a couple of years back and it was really hard to remove them. So the longer they stick on their surface, the harder it's going to get to remove them. You can also put them on tiles in your bathroom or something if you want to make a bathroom design. Just feel free to experiment, of course. Yeah, now I'm going to put them against the window and show you how they actually look when the sunlight comes through. And this is the tree version. It's still on the surface, so I didn't peel it off. I'm just holding it against the window. And so you can see where the sunlight is going to hit through. So the more light there is, the more shine through it is going to be. And also have noted that there are different kinds of colors. So this color here for the background is kind of strong. There are blues out there which are more subtle and less intense, like the yellow here, for example. This is more shine through, as you can see here when you tilt a bit higher. The brown itself is really opaque, so I did not expect this to happen. I thought it was as translucent as the rest as well. So just have a look at, yeah, the bottles, what it say. And here is the beach kind of thing. This is going to stick on its own because I reddened the backside. And this is how this is going to look like when the sun comes through. So pretty nice. I have used some night glow in the dark color for the white sky and water areas because I didn't have any white left. So this is going to, yeah, be illuminated when it's dark. But this is how this is going to look. So it is really worth trying out and experimenting with it. So it's a fun project though. So, and besides that, I hope you really enjoyed watching this video and it gave you some new information and perhaps you want to try out window color now. This video was indeed a bit different than my regular videos, but it was requested to try and so I gave it a shot. And yeah, I hope you had fun watching. If you have any questions so far, please leave me as usual in the comment box below. I will be happy to read and reply to you. If you are new to my channel and have not seen any of my other videos, please also have a look at them and give me a thumbs up if you like this video, and even better, of course, subscribe to my channel to not miss out any of my new coming videos. So far for now, thanks for watching, thanks for your time, and have a great day. Bye bye.